Yeah, I was, so first of all, thank you for the update, to the council for making the projects a priority, thank you. I guess I would ask, you know, Florida, when the hurricane season comes, when we kind of all get ready. And I would ask, what kind of storm event keeps you up at night? How much rain in a given period of time would cause you some concern based on where you are, because I know you're in the middle of a lot of these projects. And so that the war watching the radar too. So could you just kind of share with us what could cause in your mind, based on what you've done, what's in the works, a spill that would be of the type that causes council to kind of come together? Is there an event that keeps you up?
I think we're pretty well positioned now, you know, because, you know, we have not had a major event that caused the kind of flow that we got when we got those 13 and a half inches of rain.
The three hurricanes actually came through, like, yeah, about October last year. We had no event. We had rain and all that just fine. We had no event.
Yeah, we had
three hurricanes. December event would stop that. During the hurricane, something passed over about us, but we had no event.
It's an extended period of a week.
Yeah, during the hurricane.
Yeah, we got 5 inches a day, 6 inches a day, or 7 inches of rain a day for a week, and we probably experienced some conditions. We will not experience what we experienced last time. We've already positioned ourselves to the point that, and we have the equipment on ready now, that pond starts to get full, or that equalization basin starts to get full now, those trucks are rolling. So they're hauling flow from one plant over to the other. And so those guys are on standby anytime we ever bring them in.
And just, I wrote down what you said, there's 4 basins of 4 million gallons, so that's 60. And then you have 2 more of 6 million each?
Yes.
So that's 28 million right now as we sit, so we're at 28 million with up to another 8 to 10 coming online, not later than December of this year.
Hopefully.
I guess that would be my point, is that if there are delays, could we utilize that distribution list?
At one time. In our initial conversations, we was hoping that the current base would have been done now.
We're calling BPD about once a week to remind them this on the top of your desk to not forget about us.
They ought to be motivated, right? Because if it's not there, then it's an EPD problem.
They should be. We're not there only behind the state of Georgia, so that's why we call everybody. We have Scott Fowler call every week, our environmental manager, where we at. Because we'd like, said, we need to have additional questions about the great leases bill. And to me, it should have been questions that should have been much sooner than the leases bill. So we had our discussion with our rep about that we got to get this done. And we deal with state agents like that. Sometimes it slows down, but we've got these trucks in. We're trying to think ahead of what if something did happen before that basin got fully completed. There's a truck idea coming in, so we're trying every way we can not to let that happen again. But you're right, Mr. Edison, we should have been there in completion.
I can't receive a swap with that, I guess. So we're smart. You guys may not be the only one applying, you guys probably don't want to pass this major problem. And are they aware of that?
Here's what you're here. We're not, because when the hurricanes did come to the state of Georgia, it didn't affect us, but it affected other cities in Georgia much more than us. So they do have other issues in trying to handle. We understand that. But we think we should be at the top of the list. But they do have other city that had still more than we did at during the hurricane time we did in December. So there's a lot of work around the state.